Shut up and sit down.
Today is Monday, January 16th, Martin Luther King's holiday. I'm trying to edit the last video that I recorded, and I didn't go to the gym today. I went to the gym on Saturday, and I finished the plan. I plan on taking little clips here and there from different videos to show you guys what I did on Saturday. Which Saturday, what I did was to, whatever I felt like I didn't hit hard enough for during the week for the, what did I do, back workouts. So I sort of did them on Saturday. And right now I'm editing the third day video and I'm showing, you know, my warm up, and I sort of put a little clip of the first and second days next to it to show you guys the exact same thing that I did for warm up. And as I continue with the recording, I mean the editing, you know, what happened was that on Friday when I started, when I went to the gym, I wanted to do the lat pull down, the wide grip, because the last time I went to the gym, some the trainers were using, one of the trainer was using the straight bar lat pull down, and when I, you know, I said, you know, I'm not even gonna ask anything, just let him do his thing, and I have a couple other things that I wanted to do. I went and finished it, and when I was about to use it, and another member went and used it, and I said, you know what, I'll just skip it because I had to go home. I think at that time, what happened? I had to go pick up my kid. There were a couple things going on. So I didn't even stress it, and I just left it alone. So on Friday when I went to the gym, I wanted to start my workout with the straight bar lat pull down up, and I did the straight bar pull down. I think I did 7 sets. Between 10, I think I did 12 repetitions, and when after each set, I took 20-second rest, between 20 to 40-second rest. Usually the first, I'll say the first 4 or the first 5 sets, I usually take at least 15-second rest. Then once I got to 5, 6, 7, I'm usually burnt out. So that's where I usually use my whole 40 seconds of rest. So that's what happened when I was doing the straight bar lat pull down. After I did my warm up, I use the lat pull down, the cable single arm cable lat pull down. I did it in a circuit where I did, I think you guys could count between 10 and 12 repetitions per arms. And then I switch, you know, after I finish do each arm, I increase the weight, and depend on what I plan on doing. If I'm going to use both arms, like I'm showing right now, I increase the weight to a moderate weight, and I do about maybe 10 and 12 repetitions, and then I take a little rest, and then I switch the weight. You know, I don't remember what weight I put, but now I'm doing the close grip pull down. So I probably, usually I go heavy on the close grip. It's probably maybe 37 something. They have some odd numbers here, probably 32.5 or 35.5 or something like that for the weight. And then I'll take a little rest. Usually the rest is between 12 to 15 seconds. Because that's, I'm still within my one set. One set. So now I switch and I'm gonna do a different version of it. It's a crossover. Most of them I do create the my own. I create a name for it, which close enough. So I'm doing a crossover pull down, and it's really good for the muscle under your arm, your teres minor, I believe it called, or teres major. So it's really good. You feel the stretch. It's almost the same kind of movement when I lay on the bench at a 45 degree, and I have the cable, and I'm going around like as if I'm a swimmer. And I think I always say it's good for swimmers. And now I'm that's my fourth exercise. I'm doing cable. What is it? Straight. Was it straight arm pull down or something like that? And as you can see, I'm not bending that much, which I should, but because of my lower back, that's how far I could go. If I force myself to go lower than that, most likely I'm gonna feel a lot of pain in my lower back. And now in my fifth exercise, I could have used the seated cable row, but usually when I do my exercise, I like to do it, to the full of my ability. But when I do the seated with both hands, I have to do a really good stretch. And if I do that, I'm gonna hurt myself, my lower back again. So I usually do this, which helps stabilize, help with my core. So I do one arm at a time. And once my back feels much better, I'll continue do the one arm, the single arm, and I'll also do the seated one. But for now, I'm just being cautious with my lower back. And actually today, the 16th, I'm editing the video, but I did that video like on Friday. So today is my 1 year anniversary from my sciatic from last year. And last year around this time, I could not walk. Yep, I could not walk last year. So now I'm starting the third set. And I start with the crossover, the cable crossover. So each time I start a set, I start a different exercise, but it's the same group of exercises that I did on the first previous exercise set, I mean. So on this set, I'm doing the crossover first, and usually I have to go very light on this particular movement because it requires a full range of motion. So now I took a few second rest, and now I'm doing the single arm. This one I could go slightly heavy. Let me see. That's why I like to show the weights before I start. I didn't think about that when I was doing this, but it's probably 20 pound. If it's an odd number, it's within the 20s. And I switch arm. Whatever I do on one side, I do to the other. And you could see all the back muscle is very wide, so I have to be careful. I don't want my back to be too wide. I just want to be able to shape my back, but right now it's fine. But when I'm looking at it, it's a bit too wide. I don't want it to be too wide. I'm laughing because sometimes when you're taking off your sport bra, you have a hard time taking it out because your lat is too wide. So now I switch with both arms, both hands. And I increase the weight slightly, and you could look at the stacks. When the stacks of weights goes up, you could see different exercises as a different weight. And when I do the crossover, it's very light. It's the lightest that I do. Single arm, I increase it a little bit more. Close grip, that's why I go really heavy. Heavy for a woman, for me is like maybe 40 something. Or sometime even lower than that. Actually, that lady that just passed, she's the one who actually motivated me to do those videos. She was talking to me while she was passing by. So this is the close grip. You see, I stretch really, when I go up, I stretch really, as far as I can, and then I bring it straight down my sternum. That's the bone between your breast, your chest. Either way, it's the same thing. And I took a few second rest, and then I went to single arm row. See, I'm holding my side to make sure I'm feeling it, and my core should be as tight as possible. And this one I could go slightly heavy. Take a few second rest. And this one I didn't fast forward at all. You could actually do the count on your head to see how long I took between rest. That's when you do a single arm like this, it's good, to engage your core to stabilize yourself. And my legs are still a bit weak, but it's really good. And now I'm doing straight arm pull down. I think that's the way it's called. Good for the back also, the lat. Again, you could see I'm not bending that much. It's because of my lower back. I bend as far as I can, but I try to engage, squeeze the my back when the rope come toward my chest. So even though I'm not bending that much, I do engage those muscles as much as I can. And now I switch to, I'm gonna do my different group of exercises. The area that I usually use is being used, is being occupied by another member. And usually this machine, right now I'm doing a crossover. This machine, it look fancy, but I do not like it. The weight on this machine, it seems like I could go to 100 sometimes. I do. Sometimes I put the weight to like 100 when I'm doing certain type of movements, and it doesn't feel heavy at all. But the other machine, the lifestyle machine, when I put 20 or 10 or 5, I feel like I'm lifting a 20 or 5 or 10, whatever the amount of weight that I'm putting. But this one, I don't know. There's something strange about it. I don't trust the numbers that's underweight because sometimes I go heavy, I still don't feel like I'm lifting the amount that I put. So, in this group of exercise, that as you can see, there's not too many things you can do here. But when I'm on the other side of the gym, where I did my first, second workout, first day and second day, that little area, it has the dumbbells, the barbells, and stuff like that. I usually make up my workout really quick. And when I'm in this area, I'm very limited. Unless if I have a specific thing to do or whatever. I knew I was gonna work my back, but the type of exercises that I wanna do, I'll have to grab all the weights and all the stuff to come over here to do them. So it's usually difficult for me to make up my workout. So as you can see, I did the crossover and I did the single arm, what is it, the barbell at the end, the row, and now I'm doing the reverse fly. So after I did this exercise, I don't think I did any other things, any other exercise after I did the fly. Oh, I think I did lateral raises and front raises. That's 2 pounds I'm using. Other weight that I wanted to use were being occupied by another member. So I think the next heaviest that was available was like a 20, but the kind of exercise that I wanted to do, 20 would be too heavy for me. So I grabbed the lightest that was left, which was a 5 pound. So as you can see, I did my reverse fly with the 5 pound. And for the front and lateral raises, you see what I did? I put both 5 pounds together to do the front and lateral raises. So that become a 10 pounds right there. Sometimes you have to use your imagination to accomplish your goal. So the weight that I wanted was being used, so the next lightest that I could use was the 5. If I went with a 20, there's no way I'll be able to. I mean, I probably will be able to do the front and lateral raises, but I won't be able to do it with full control, and you know, so it's better to go light. So now this exercise is really good. It's good for chest too. But sometimes when I'm doing back, I like to do it because it helps stretch the muscles both direction. If I go back, it stretch the front, your chest. And then when you go forward, you pull it down, it really helps the back. So I like to do it. And I think the reason I did it here because I was limited with the amount of exercises that I wanted to do. So I decided to do that. And after I did my first set, the group of exercises, the crossover, the front raises, the lateral raises, the row, all of that, I didn't feel tired at all. Usually my heart rate is up when I finish do those kind of exercises in the circuit. I was like, I need to bring some more stuff. So I decided to go back. I grabbed some, a 40-pound dumbbell, and I think it was a 30 barbell to do some shoulder presses and stuff like that. So this is, I didn't really calculate the first set. Whatever, it could be one set, but I think I ended up doing two sets after that anyway. So that's a 40-pound dumbbell. I'm doing some row, even though the bar and at the end I do the row also. It just feels different, so I just a different variation. It doesn't hurt to do the row in different ways. So here I use the bench to stabilize myself. In this area, the trainers usually occupy the space. But even though the gym doesn't look that packed, but the area that I usually am was being occupied. So the things that I wanted to do, I couldn't do it. I mean, I could probably squeeze myself somewhere to do what I need to do, but the major, the lifestyle cable resistant was being occupied, so I just came over here. And here I'm doing the barbell row. Again, you can see I'm pretty looking at it now, it's not that bad. I bent pretty far, I guess because my other hand was on my knees to help stabilize me. Yeah, I have my hands on my knees, so I went pretty low. But normally I can't really go that far down because of my back. So looking at it now, it wasn't bad at all. I bent down a little bit low enough. Now I switch it. I'm gonna put, I think it was a 25 pound to do some front raises. It's just a different variation. It doesn't hurt to do different variation. It's good for the delt and your chest too, your delt and pec, your upper pec. You guys could count. I lose count. If I don't write them down, I lose count in terms of sets or whatever. Even during the repetition, sometimes I lose count. So I usually do extra just in case. So here I go back to the reverse fly. Same exercises. I just added the 40-pound dumbbell. And where did I put the barbell, the 30 pound? You can see when I got up, my back was, it wasn't hurting, but it just that uncomfortableness from being in that position. And I went back to do the front and lateral raises. Still using the 2 pound, not 2 pound, the 2 5-pound dumbbells. I actually was trying to hurry up because it was a Friday. My son had a half a day, so I wanted to really hurry up and get it out the way. I put my camera by a door. Very rarely you see anybody walk through that door, and the room back there, nobody was there, so I didn't think anybody would be going through. So I put the camera a little pretty much behind the door. Most people say, what a dumb position. But nobody was there, and very rarely anybody used that door. So the cleaner, the person, the lady was, she didn't see it. Luckily I saw it because we just got that camera because we ran over our old camera. Long story. We dropped it, we didn't even realize it. We ran over it with our car. It's not funny because that was the, actually like it better than this new one. The old one, while you're recording, you could take pictures. And this one, you can do both at the same time. You have to stop one to do the other. And the same exercise as the first set is just that in different order. Usually it's good to do it in different sequence. That way, whatever muscles that was fresh when you first did any particular movement, when you do it a different way, a different sequence, it tends to feel different. That's my opinion. It's just sometime I do that. I usually take a few second rest. Here I'm doing the crossover again. Usually I take the handle out. It's just I'm being lazy because I'm gonna use the resistance for a different movement, so I kept it. See, I try not to go bring my hands close together. When you do that, you lose the resistance. So I bring it a little bit close. You could look at the weight stack. It doesn't go completely down on the stack when my hand comes forward. So I kept the resistance very, I keep the resistance going so I could still feel it. I have to fight it, you know, with my muscles. Yeah, I'm doing a face pull. And when I do the face pull on the other machine, I think it's usually, what is it? Is it 27 or something? Here it was like maybe the weight on this one was probably 60 or 70. And it still didn't feel heavy. But I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna kill myself. But I don't like working out on this machine at all. Look fancy, but the weight is manipulated. Maybe it's in kilo. Next time I go there, I have to look if it's in pound or kilo or something like that. Here I'm doing the, what is it, shoulder presses with the 30 pound. I believe it was a 30, not 40. Sometimes I switch front and back. I think I did 6 rep going back and 6 rep going in the front. And it usually, you know, when you do the switching like that, you feel it right away. Instead of doing, let's say, one set, you just go in one direction. Here, this is my third set, and I believe that was the final set. With the shoulder presses, when you go in one direction, there's nothing wrong with it. But when you switch back and forth, either front and back, or whatever, you feel it right away because you're pretty much tricking the muscles. You know, the muscles are guessing, you know, which way, you know, you're gonna do the movement, and it becomes very tiring quickly. I sometimes do it with dumbbells too, where I use different hand position to do the presses. And by the time you get to 6, 7, 8 reps, your shoulders are burning. So there are times I do that. Or I will do the first 2 sets where I switch back and forth. And then on the last set, I probably will do it really heavy, just going in one direction. So sometimes you know, I play around with the weight like that. When I'm switching back and forth, I go very light. But when I go in one particular direction, or hand position or hand grip, I go heavy, because the muscles is just keep, you know, already registered, is gonna go in one direction. But when you go different direction, you go supinated, pronated, or neutral hand grip, you switch back and forth. You could do 2 pronated, 2 supinated. When I said 2, I mean like 2 reps going supinated and 2 reps going pronated. Your muscles get really tired very quickly. So yeah, that was just sidetrack a little bit. Here I'm doing the row again with the bar. It's the same thing as same movement with the dumbbell, just a different variation. Yeah, I start putting the stuff away. As I finish or complete my workout, I start putting them away. And that also, you know, give other members hint. If they're watching or if they want to use certain things, they starting realizing that you're almost finished. So that's one, it's one of those things sometimes when you're in public, you want to be fair. You could see who's using what, and when they're in the middle of their sets or something like that, you give them their privacy. And some people, you know, they just want to be an ass, and just because they're a member, you know, they feel like they have the right. But, you know, out of respect or whatever, you know, you just show the decency or respect, let them do their stuff the same reason you want to do your stuff. So when I see if, for instance, there are times, as you can see, the gym is not that packed, I can use at least, especially on legs, I could use at least 4 or 5 machines at the same time, just going on the circuit. And then when one person wants to use it, I don't go, oh, I'm using it, and meanwhile, I'm using leg press, I'm using this. No, I say, go ahead, take it, because I know I'm using all 3. It would not be fair for me to hug them for like 40 minutes and just because I want to do my workout. No, nobody's there using it. Yes, I'll do it. But if people wants to use it while I'm occupying 3 or 4 machines at the same time, eventually, you know, you just have to let them use it. You can only use 1 at a time. So a lot of time when you know, trainers, they see me doing a couple exercises, they say, using it? I was like, yeah, I was using it, but you can use it. They're on a clock, they have clients, so it's not a big deal to me. I could always use different machines to do different exercise. And like, for instance, look, I'm doing the front raises of the 2 5 pounds. Yes, I need the 10 pound or the 15 pound, but someone was using it and the lightest that they had was a 5 pound. So I grab both 5 pounds and do what I need to do. Yeah, my heart rate was like really going. It was so bad. After I did the first set, I was like, oh, I just finished everything that I need to do. And I look at my watch and my heart rate wasn't high at all. So I went and grabbed a couple more stuff. I said, I need to do some more stuff. Because eventually I probably was gonna do them on the other side anyway. On this particular set, I think I did, what is it, either 10 or 12 reps going front, and 10 or 12, whatever repetition that I did, I kept it on one side. I did the lateral and the front raises on the same side. Usually I switch, let's say I do lateral raises with the left, and then I'll switch, I do lateral raises with the right. And then I'll switch back again, do front raises with the left, switch and do front raises with the right. I usually switch like that to at least give each arm some rest. And I think I did it in the first and second set. The third set, I decided to do all, both the lateral and the front, both on the same side, and then I switch. So that's one particular variation sometimes you have to play. I just finished the crossover, and now I raise the, what is it, the stack or the resistance. And like I said before, this thing is mostly for stretch the muscles. It's really good for your back and your chest. I'm looking at my arm here. I never really pay attention to it, but looking at it right now, it's looking pretty defined. I like it the way it is. It's not too big and too muscular, just right. You say. And the sun was just beaming in that section, and then the other side is always dark for some reason. They have light, but the lighting during the day is not that bad. I mean, it's not too bright. Switch with the other arm. For the first two videos, I didn't really do that much voiceover, especially the first one. Oh my god, I was exhausted. It took me 3 days to actually finish editing it and do what I needed to do. So pretty much the first video, it took me forever to finish, and the second one, it took me I think 2 days to finish edit. And this one I started last night, and I just did some work with the kids, and I decided to let me try to edit it. Now I'm doing the shoulder press with the barbell. See, I'm switching back and forth. I think it was a 30 pounds. I do front and back. Sometimes I do 2 reps in front, 2 reps in the back, switch back and forth until I do at least 12. Sometimes during the workout, actually I was done. The 3 sets were complete. So now I decided to do some biceps and triceps. So here I'm doing single arm. I like to do one arm at a time. First, so at least, you know, make sure the muscles are actually doing the work before I do with both arms. And here I'm using the rope. My arm was already tired. You see, the first rep, I went to the side. I usually do it like that, where I push, when I push the rope down and I rotate my wrist to make the rope go a little bit further. My arm was already beat with just the first set. So I did, I think maybe 12 reps, but the first set, the way I did it was, I was like, I'm not even gonna do it like that. My arm is exhausted. So now I only did 1 set, and now I'm doing the biceps. You know, I always tell people that I, when they ever they ask me what I do for my arms and stuff like that, I always tell them the same thing. I never make a day for arms or shoulders. It's just that when I do either chest or back, I always add a little biceps or a tricep within the workout. And yeah, So as you can see, on this particular video, I only did one set. One set. The first, each set was, I started with a single arm, and then I went with both arms, and that's about it. If you do your exercises right, you don't need to kill yourself to see result. And here, I think it probably was maybe 190 pounds or something like that. It still didn't feel heavy. I really think, I have to look at the weight on the weight stack. It's probably in kilos or something like that. It can be, because I'm seeing 40, 50 or something like that on the... But anyway, pretty much I was done, and here I'm gonna jump up on that thing to stretch my arms, shoulders, and everything. And I usually do this when I do my obliques, but I didn't really work my my abs that day. It was already late, so I was trying to, this thing was there, so I said, you know what, let me just stretch a little bit, and that's about it. And here I'm showing the time, it's 10:11, and I burned 240 something calories, and my highest heart rate was 148. My training time was an hour, 57 minutes. So I got home and I'm putting those information and to my computer, which is for people who's gonna watch my blog. This is what I usually do. Actually, on Wednesday, time is messed up. I don't know what happened. It's showing 00, but my workout time was messed up. And my watch doesn't, how do you call this? Keep, it has memories. If you go back, let's say today is Monday, the 16th. If I work out yesterday, the 15th, I can look at my workout from yesterday. But once I record my day, my workout day, it overwrite the first day. So, yeah. But anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.
Calories burnt 445, and I work out for only 40 minutes or so. I was in my heart rate zone for 1 hour and 20 minutes. Well, 1 hour 20 minutes and 8 seconds, and that was 73%. It says there I did 1 hour and 49 minutes workout, but technically it's only 40 minutes. I walked to the supermarket to get some stuff, and I had to hurry because my son has a half a day today, and I wanted to get some stuff at the supermarket for them to eat, like bread and what is it? Actually, I might even show you guys, because I'm gonna go to the So I did back and a little bit of, let me see, I did back and I did a little bit of minor shoulders. It wasn't a lot of shoulders, and I did one set of biceps, buys and tries, and I did shoulders. Let me copy this. Copy. And then. Today's workout. I record, I think, everything that I did. Then I'll get my So this is a receipt of the supermarket. They Tuesday, today is the 13th, and it was around 10:39 a.m. And I think I have time of when I stopped working out. So I think I did pretty well, because I think I had $25 in my $25 in change with me, and I said, you know what, I want to spend only $20. And the three main things that I wanted to get was eggs. It and that came to I'm gonna eat some corn. I had it in the freezer for a while, so that's what I'm gonna have with my coffee. So I did all the math in my head, and it came, I was very proud of myself when at the checkout. I knew it would be $20 and change, you know, with tax and all this stuff. So I ended up spending, $20.57. And I give the exact change. So that was pretty good. And that's what I bought right after I work out. And
I decided to put some pictures together for you guys to see. This was the day three of the back workout. And this one is day one. And this one is day two of the back workout. There's some minor improvement, but not major. And here I put all 3 days. The one in the middle, which was the second day, I did them. I took the pictures in the locker room. Nobody was there, so I took a picture of it. And actually, I have to fix that on the second video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.